Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I acknowledge the Honourable Vijayanath for this question. Mr. Speaker, in responding to the question by the Honourable Member, let me just say that the engagement with our international defence and security partners is very, very important in our relations and, of course, in addressing issues that we face. One, let me say, Mr. Speaker, that this is consistent with our foreign policy. We, as a small country, we are friends to all and enemies to none, because it is important for us in terms of our survival and, of course, being relevant as well within the dynamics of geopolitics within the region. On that, Mr. Speaker, sir, we have areas of common interest with this international and bilateral partners, and of course they support our development aspirations, and of course the respect of our sovereignty as well. That is something in terms of our foreign policies that I wish to state while addressing this question. Mr. Speaker, sir, why the increase in engagements now? There are a few drivers. Let me just mention a few. One is the geopolitical shifts in the region. Some may say competition. There is an increased presence. There is an increased competition in the region for many obvious reasons. I will not go into the details. And then there are risks and threats as well. Mr. Speaker, sir, I think I have mentioned this a few times in this August House. When we look at conventional threats, we can say that we are safe. But then, when you look at non-traditional threats, which is sort of the norm today, in areas like terrorism, for example, IUU, illegal unreported unregulated fishing, with such a big maritime country with a big EEZ, and there's a lot of activities happening in our maritime zone. The issues on human trafficking and drug trafficking. And then we have the threats of climate change and disaster. These are the new emerging threats. And of course, the new partnerships is very, very critical for us as well. The development trends, Mr. Speaker, sir, developments are good. But as we all know, it comes with opportunities and challenges as well. And this morning we talked about crime and drug, and that has been the issue of discussion this week in this August House, because this is a result of the developments that have taken place, and we just need to be aware and, of course, prepare accordingly as well. Mr. Speaker, sir, in terms of our engagements, we have engagements at the multilateral level. I can quote the Board Declaration for the region in terms of the Pacific Islands Forum. And of course, we have, in peacekeeping, we contribute to the global peace security. And this is the engagement that we have as well. And of course, we have bilateral relations as well. And if I might quote a few of the key ones, with Australia, we have the Defence Cooperation Programme, DCP, as you are well aware of, Mr. Speaker, sir. And with New Zealand, we have the MAP, the Mutual Assistance Programme. These are programmes in place And of course, we have our partners, the USA. We have the ship rider agreement with them. And right now, as we speak, we have troops from the US on exercise with the 3rd Battalion in Vanuatu. We have the UK as well, India, Japan. Some countries we have defense cooperation programs, otherwise we just have MOUs or an umbrella cooperation arrangement. This is where all these relations, and of course I've talked about our foreign policies, and this is the link between our foreign policy and military diplomacy as well. We have to be seen to be engaged. What are the benefits? Mr. Speaker, sir, I've talked about the threats, and we as a small country, we have limited capacities and capabilities, and we cannot handle this alone. And if I may just quote Australia, for example, Mr. Speaker, sir, the heads of border agencies and the chiefs of security had meetings in Fiji early this year, and there's another meeting organized in Australia in October this year for this. So the benefit is we as small countries will be able to work together with our friends and partners to enhance our own local arrangements in as far as security risks and threats are concerned. Likewise, Mr. Speaker, sir, in terms of interoperability, we need to be have an understanding with the foreign forces on how to work with them, terminologies, technologies, best practices. I'll use Cyclone Winston for an example. It was very easy for the Australian Defence Force and the New Zealand Defence Force to fit into the arrangements that we have here because of this cooperation and the regular exercises and training that we have with them. Compared to Vanuatu, when we had Cyclone Pam in 2015, it was a big issue for them because Vanuatu only has a police force. They don't have such arrangements that we have. So interoperability, this is very, very important. And then the sharing of information and platforms, Mr. Speaker, sir. Very soon, members of this August House will be hearing the terms like fusion centers. That's the way we are doing things now, fusion centers. There's a fusion center now. I'm not sure if some members of the committee has been to the naval base. There's a fusion center there now. Particularly, and in that fusion center, although it's in the military, in the naval base, we have fisheries 24/7 and customs there 24/7. And decisions and sharing of information is made there and then. These are the new platforms in terms of sharing of information, not only domestically, but these centers have connections to other to our neighbors as well. And next week in Tuvalu, there will be discussions about a regional fusion center so that we have our own domestic arrangements, and then these national centers will have a link to the regional, because no country can afford to work in isolation, because we need to share this. And of course, best practices and technology as well, Mr. Speaker, sir. We have to partner with our foreign partners. I'll quote satellite, for example. We don't have our own satellites, but we can ride on the satellites offered by our bigger partners as it transits our region. We can access live data from these satellites. And of course, we can use it, and that enhances the security arrangements that we have. Those are some of the benefits and the background behind these arrangements, Mr. Speaker, sir.